Hello, good to see you again. I'm Teacher July, and today I'm going to talk about how to make Google Slides interactive using Pear Deck. Lots of teachers, including me, are trying real hard to figure out a way to engage more students for remote class these days due to COVID-19 break. I think Pear Deck can be the answer. Using Pear Deck, we can make Google Slides lessons more interactive. Students can respond to the questions the teacher asked in real time, and I can get to watch their learning progress. And the best thing is, it's really easy to use and free. If you like the tips that I share in this video, don't forget to click on like button down there and subscribe to my channel. First of all, I'll show you how to make Google Slides interactive using Pear Deck, and then I'll show you what it looks like on the student's view when you go present, so you can get a sense of what it'd be like to use it in the online live session. Okay, let's get started. To use this Pear Deck, you need to install Google Slides Pear Deck add-ons first. Here, add-ons, click on it. And get add-ons here. You get many add-ons here, but you will select Pear Deck and install it. Once you install that, then you can see this little menu bar up here and click on it. And you can see this Pear Deck sidebar on the right side. There are templates that you can choose from, and they are editable. However, this time I will show you how to transform normal Google Slides into interactive ones using Pear Deck. So you will see on the right side here, there are all the different question types available to you. For example, okay, so now Pear Deck has upgraded, so you can show any video clip to your students during the lecture. So I will make them watch this video, and then after watching the video, I want to ask students some questions about this video. I want students to respond in multiple choice form, so click on this choice button on this Pear Deck sidebar, okay. And then there is a pop-up to fill up the options, right? You can delete it or add more options. Okay, then after you finish this, then click on this update slide button down there. You cannot see the multiple question right now, because it's going to pop up when you start presenting. But down there, you see little Pear Deck box and the notes section here, right? It makes your slides interactive, so don't erase this. If you wanna edit the options, so go back to the sidebar and click on this choice button. Then you can see the pop-up to add it. And I want to add this draggable type of question. It's for only premium versions. So when you sign up, you are on 90 days of trial to use premium features, so don't miss it. It's quite fun to use. Students can drag the dots or the icons. So click on this draggable here. You can change the colors or the shapes, or you can add more items, or you can resize it like this, and then click on this update slide button. And you can see here, students drag the icons. Okay, after that, I want my students write the phone number, so click on this text button right here on the sidebar. And then they can type the answer on their device. And then next one, draw button here. I can make stones to draw. Okay, which is also a premium feature, so use it while you can. Students can draw with their mouse on their device with this button. So click on it. So students can draw anywhere on this slide. Okay, now it's time to show what it looked like on teacher's view and students' view when you go live with this Pear Deck slides. So click on this start lesson up here. I will talk about the student paced activity later in my next video, so let's focus on this instructor paced mode today. Once you click on it, you can see this pop-up about the teacher dashboard, right? So just click on got it, and then this link to give students, and you make sure that your students get this link, or they can type the class code here on joinp.com. So this is what teacher's view looks like here when it's just watch on live stream, and this is here, this is for the screen on student's device. On teacher's dashboard, you can see just one student connected here, which is me, right? And you can start whenever you and your students are ready. Don't worry for the students who haven't joined the session yet, because the join code here will be shown up here during the entire session. Okay, so click on continue here. You can see when I move on to the next slide like this, and the students will follow automatically because I'm on the instructor mode. The first one, I added up a multiple question here, so this on the student's end, they can see the options to choose. Once they answered, I can show their responses by clicking this here show responses button. Okay, so click here. There are two options, grid layout or overlay layout. So this one is, okay, this grid layout means you can see students' individual answers, and then this one is overlay layout means you can see all the students' answers from all of your students on one slide. Okay, I can move on to the next slide. On the student end, they can see two draggable dots and hearts. Okay, so they can move the icons like this way. So when I click this show responses button down there, I can see what they're doing like this. Right? And move on to the next slide. Okay, students can write the answer in this box. Okay, so just write the number like students here. Then I can see their response like this. They can draw they want, and then clicking show responses button here, then I can see what they're drawing. And then like this way, grid layout or overlay layout. So if you wanna finish the lesson, then click on this end button down there. Session as 3, And then you see this publish student takeaways. If you click on this, you'll see that I have so you will see that I have a link to all my students' responses in my Google Drive that I could share with my students. Okay, that's all for today's video. I hope this video useful to you. If you found this video helpful, click the like button down there and subscribe to my channel. Good luck with your remote class. Bye!